Matt Hamilton was a leader on May 3, 2023 before this, when a Ripple official said that the company wanted to make a special XRP ledger for digital currencies issued by central banks. It made a stir. Hamilton talked about the Bitcoin business from his point of view. He is now making changes to the EURR, a private form of the XRP ledger for digital currencies backed by the government. Even though what Ripple's head of developer relations said was important, people started to wonder if the value of XRP on this code over record matches what most people think it's worth, or if it's something completely different. Black Swan investors aren't the same thing. Venture investors even shared pictures of the shocking $3,700 price of XRP on this mystery network, saying they had seen this hidden ledger. Getting the usual amount of chatter going. If you're new, don't forget to add yourself and ring the bell to get the latest news about our XRP issues. Please show me some love by giving my work a thumbs up and leaving a review with what you think. There were a lot of arguments about how much XRP really costs on this private version, and even about the truth of the record itself after this information came out. However, this is where things get more difficult. We just heard a podcast clip that talked about the Republic of Palau. What does it mean? It's important to know that Ripple and the Republic of Palau have worked together before. That is, when they led the first trial of a safe coin based on the XRP ledger. It stands to reason that these people should know the XRP price on this mysterious ledger and how it works. We solved this mystery on today's show. Get ready to see a movie with the Republic of Palau's finance minister in it. Are you ready for some deep dives? Deep into the argument about whether ledgers should be private or public, how their stablecoin works, and how much XRP might be worth. Anyhow, let's go to the video right away. The main reason we picked the public RP ledger was that it was open to everyone. Paramount has always put a high value on being open about our ongoing projects and major accomplishments. So far, the trip has been fun, even though there have been some problems. Ripple's creative work, trial and error, and help have been very important in getting past these problems. At the end of the movie, this is seen in the Republic of Palau's money situation. It was clear that the ministry put the public first. Ledger for being open, but their claim doesn't prove or disprove the existence of a secret ledger, so anything could happen in the future. A lot of people want to know how much this secret record is said to be worth. We got this audio clip from another show, and it will now play. This will make it clear that the XRP prices that are used for speculation on this secret platform are correct. There is an idea that the public and private ledgers may eventually match up. If this is true, their prices could be added together. By finding the average but not having any real proof, this is still just a guess. First, let us talk about the expected price on the XRP private ledger. This price is not set in stone, but it gives us an idea of how much the private ledger might value XRP. David Short, who many people know as Ripple's CTO, was there for the whole thing. I will say again what I already said because it is so complicated. There is a secret ledger. It's not just any old thing. I saw this happen during a live YouTube video from Japan. During that 5-minute show, I also learned about the public record. The question now is, how do they tell the difference between XRP notes? A huge amount of work goes into both public and private ledgers, but let's not lose sight of my main point in all this information. There will come a time when the lines between the public and private ledgers will blend together. But before that day comes, we need clear, strong rules to make sure there is no doubt when they do start to work. At the same time, it looks like they are still in the trial phase of this. The secret ledger is currently adding a large amount of information. The Bank of Japan is now known as SBI, which gives this story a new twist. Recently said they were going to get into the XRP loan business. This is an important move because it shows that big financial companies are interested in XRP. This new lending facility makes the bank's goal of using XRP for business deals stand out. It also doesn't make sense. What would Japan have to do with XRP loans if they didn't think cryptocurrencies would be important? The point of view I'm moving towards will become very convincing in the end. The Bank of Japan made a well-thought-out strategic choice after running a number of tests to see how much institutional and individual investors wanted XRP. It's not just that they're lending it that's well-thought-out. XRP is more appealing than just its trading value. It was created by banks as a way to make money off of the growing popularity of cryptocurrencies. One possible use for it is for large-scale cross-border retail consumer transactions. We're also seeing a big change in how businesses deal with each other. This is a long-term trend. Financial institutions use XRP to power useful projects by making it easy to send money within and between institutions and to pay people in other countries. Global banking giants are getting together, but only in Japan, for example. MasterCard is not only a credit card company, but it is also a partner of Ripple. With this partnership, Ripple is more than just a huge company that handles payments. It's a broad network of related businesses. The collaboration between MasterCard's main division and its numerous subsidiaries, such as Yak Dareth, Fluency Consensus, and countless more not even included here, highlights liquidity and possible scale in addition to sponsorship. There is some truth to the reports that MasterCard and Ripple work towards the single strategic goal of using Ripple as the main payment processor. From the beginning, this is just a role and I'm trying to bring you all the news, hearsay, and bits and pieces of information that are going about. I want everyone to keep in mind that my idea about why MasterCard might have partnered with XRP is just that, a theory. Yes, they worked with Ripple, and it's a known fact that the XRP cryptocurrency and its ledger are what power RippleNet's architecture that allows for on-demand liquidity. Therefore, if MasterCard uses Ripples, they're actually using XRP. Having stated that, MasterCard would automatically use the XRP ledger if it decided to support Ripple payments. Though theoretical, this insight highlights the seriousness of such a collaboration and its possible ramifications. Please keep in mind that I'm not a licensed financial advisor and that the information in these movies is only meant for your amusement. I always advise viewers that before making any financial decisions, they should do their own research and speak with experts. I appreciate you watching, and if you liked the video, please click the like button. Also, don't forget to enable the alert so you can be the first to know when I upload new content. I can't wait to see you in the next video. Be careful.